Well, I believe I found his problem. His boat sunk. What's up, guys? It's Brian again from Lake Hickory Scuba Marina. If you are new to our channel, do me a huge favor. Click this little subscribe button right here and ding that little bell as well. That way you guys will be notified every time we upload new content. Now today we're headed out for another dive salvage, and we've got a runabout, a 20-foot runabout that has sunk at a local marina here on our lake. And so we're going to head out, we're going to see if we can determine what made it sink and then what we need to do to lift it up. Now, we actually got this call yesterday, which was the previous video you guys just watched. And the guy said, hey, my boat sunk, don't know what it made it sunk, but I need it up quick. How quick can you get here? Well, unfortunately, we couldn't make it out on that day. So we told him it'd be the next day around lunchtime before we could get there. And that's what we're doing. We're headed out to go get a boat up. I don't suspect it's going to be difficult. He actually sent me some pictures of it, of where it's at. The bow is actually sticking up out of the water a little bit, so I don't think we're going to have that much trouble getting it up out of the water. The only hiccup I could see, of course, is it's in a slip at a dock system, and being in that slip, we're going to have limited room to actually work. So once I get down there, I'm going to do a quick inspection and see what it looks like, and then, of course, we will get started. All right, guys, so we're going to go ahead and kick off this salvage job, and I got to be honest with you, this is probably one of the easiest salvage jobs I've ever done. We had a couple little hiccups, which we'll discuss here, but basically what I'm doing now is I'm explaining to the owners of the vessel what our plan is and how we plan on getting this boat up and floating on its own. And I'm going to go ahead and make my entry. And if you notice, we're at a dock system here, and we're having to work in between the walkways of the dock. And that was one of the hassles we had, is we had a limited space to operate. Now, the first thing I'm going to do, of course, is go down and do a quick inspection of the vessel. I'm looking for damage. I'm looking to see if the plug's in it. I'm looking for rigging points. I'm looking for anything that'll give me information on, first of all, what made it sink, and number two, what's going to be the easiest and efficient way to lift it up. Now, as I go towards the stern of the vessel, you're going to notice a metal bar. This is a crossmember bar that goes between the two dock systems. And this is actually our saving grace on this job, because if it wasn't for this crossmember here, this vessel would have just went on down. So that's actually what's holding the stern up at this point. And it's what really made this job a whole lot easier for us. But I'm going to go ahead and conduct an inspection here. I'm going to look at the boot, which is around the outdrive area. Look to see if it's dry rotted or been eaten out by muskrats. Also looking there to see if the plug's in place, to make sure no water can come in there, or if that's where water did come in. And I'm just doing an overall inspection of the hull as well, looking for damage to see if the vessel's been wrecked or to see if someone has actually ran into it to put a hole in it. And we do this for a couple of things. You know, first of all, we film these for you guys here on YouTube. We want you guys to learn from us, but we also film it for our personal liability as a salvage company. We can turn this information over to law enforcement if we need to. If it's an investigation, we can turn it over to insurance companies as well. So that's why we film this. And it protects us from a liability standpoint as well. But there you can see the vent that's next to the gunwale. That's a very important part of the vessel that we need to be concerned with, because as we go to raise this vessel, we have to make sure those vents are out of water before we start pumping. Now, like I said, we are in a dock system here, so we do have a limited space to operate in between, say, the dock and the vessel itself. So that was really the only hiccup that we had here, is the limited space. But with that being said, after I finish my inspection, I'm going to kind of go ahead and talk to the surface crew now, let them know what I found and what my suggestions are on getting this vessel up. And we're going to devise a plan that's going to make it easy for us and a quick, successful job as well. So what we've kind of decided to do is take two 2,000-pound subsalve lift bags, and we're going to go ahead and anchor shackle them together. Now, typically, we'll use some type of belly band system, but in this case, we decided not to do that just because we do have limited space. We didn't want to strap off, and this vessel has a pretty decent ski rack that's going to give us an attachment point to where we can tie the outside part of the bags and onto the vessel just to kind of hold it in place. So we're going to anchor shackle two 2,000-pound lift bags together, and we're going to shimmy them up underneath the vessel. We're going to put one on one side, one on the other side, and of course the center part of them will be up underneath the hull itself. And then these subsail bags have these attachment rings on the top, and these are secured rings where you can tie ropes or whatever type of strap system you need to lock it into place. That's what we're actually going to be using to hold the bags in place. Now, you want to be careful when you do this. If you use even the ski racks that we're using, or if you're using some type of anchor cleat, you can rip that stuff out if you ain't careful. But considering that we are keeping these separate, or you know, shackled together, it's going to kind of keep them in place, and we're going to have an equal amount of lift as we go to lift. Now, typically when we lift like this, if we're not using tanks, we're going to use some type of manifold system on a compressor unit. And the cool thing about that manifold is we can actually control how much air goes into each bag at any given time. So once I have this separated, or have these bags spread out evenly, I can actually control how much air goes into both bags with the manifold system. And that's going to help me keep that vessel balanced at the surface as well, because a lot of times these V-holes, they'll actually roll on you as you lift them, especially if they're sitting on the bottom. But I'm going to go ahead and secure the bag off here, just using just a standard rope. This is basically just the dock line to temporarily hold it in place. Like I said, I am tying it around the ski rack there. And I'm going to do that on both rings. So there's two rings on the bag that I'm using here, and there's two rings on the other bag that the other salvage guy has on the other side. And we're just going to secure them in place. And before we even attempt to start the pumping process, we want to make sure that everything is evenly dispersed. So as we go to lift, that vessel comes up evenly, and it's not going to roll to one side or the other. Now, with that, we are going to put some other measures in place to help us out. Once we start to lift, we are going to tie the vessel off in 4 points. So if it does happen to roll, or we have a bag shift in any way, it will be locked into place and it won't roll on us. We're also going to take a salvage guy. We're just going to kind of set him on the vessel itself, and that way he can kind of keep it rocking in the right place and keep it stabilized. But now we got everything attached, it's time to lift it up. So as you can see, we got a compressor here in the background. We got our salvage guy on the front keeping it balanced, and you can see our bag starting to lift up. You'll also notice that we are pumping water out of it. We've got two pumps put in there. We've got one down in the engine bay. We've also got one down in the hull through the access panel on the floor, and we're just pumping away. One of the things that's very boring about doing jobs like this is the pumping process. That's usually what takes us the longest time to do. But we've pretty much got the boat floating now. We're going to continue to pump it out, and then we will pull one of our tow vessels around and hook to it, and we will pull the vessel over to the boat ramp so that the owner can put it up on his trailer. After that, we simply give him an invoice, and that's pretty much going to be it for this dive, guys. Yeah, it's a pretty simple job. That cross member really helped us out. There you go, guys. Another successful salvage job done. This one was actually very easy. We had a crossbar member that went from one dock pole to the other dock pole that kind of held that boat in place for us, so that prevented it from going down anymore. This was actually a relatively easy job, but it was a nasty job. There was literally oil everywhere, and typically when you have a boat sink, you're going to have gas and oil come up and kind of pollute the water a little bit. But this job was extremely nasty. He had a hose or a line or something that had busted, and there was just black crude and oil everywhere on the inside of this vessel, and it was pretty bad. The suit that I wore in this video was one of my older 3 mils that, you know, it didn't matter how much I cleaned it, it's not going to come out, so that's why I wore that. But yeah, it's a pretty bad job as far as that's concerned. But as far as the lift, super easy. We bellied it, threw two bags on it, lifted it up, pumped it out, towed it, and the rest is history. But guys, I really hope you enjoyed today's video. If you like these videos, give me a big thumbs up. Definitely share them. Drop me a comment down below what you want to see. Do you want more salvage videos? Do you want review videos? Do you want teaching videos? Let me know down in the comment section what you guys want to see, and we'll produce it for you. But guys, as always, make sure you follow us on Instagram and Twitter, like us on Facebook, pin us on Pinterest, subscribe to us here on YouTube, and as always, guys, we appreciate your business.